because you're having an issue with your vacuum cleaner, causing part of the power to trip in your heart. Part of the power to trip in your house. It's a little bit of a tongue twister. So you're having an issue with your vacuum cleaner, tripping the power, and it's frustrating because it doesn't happen in all parts of your house, just maybe in the bedrooms or certain areas. So where I found this happen was first with a client where we helped them sell their 1950s Rambler and then helped them buy a 2010 somewhere on in their house. They were vacuuming when they first moved in and they were having no problems in the living room, having no problems vacuuming the hallways. But then they got to their bedroom, started vacuuming. Ooh, pew. Is that how electrical circuits sound when you turn them off? Pop. We'll say pop or just click. It's just the sound of the vacuum cleaner going off and hitting the button. Can't figure out why the vacuum cleaner turned off. They go down to the basement to the electrical panel. They see that the circuit is tripped, turn it back on. But why is this happening? Why is it happening only in certain areas of the house? And why is it only happening after a little while? It doesn't happen immediately. The culprit for this is a little device in your electrical breaker box called the arc fault circuit interrupter, or AFCI. Now, this isn't to be confused with a ground fault circuit interrupter, or GFCI. The GFCI protects against electrical shock or electrocution. These outlets are usually placed in wet areas of the house, places like bathrooms, kitchens, garage, outdoor outlets, anywhere that there's more of a concern of electrical shock because of water and electricity potentially mixing together. So that's not to be confused with the AFCI, or arc fault circuit interrupter. This is a newer device. This is started around the mid-90s. And in some of the newer houses, or if you've had your electrical system overhauled, you'll probably see these in your electrical panel. The AFCI is meant to protect if it notices any potential arcing or sparking in wiring. Now, the issue is that the motors in a lot of vacuum cleaners, they look like arcing to the AFCI. So it shuts it down. It says, I'm going to protect you from a house fire. But the issue is it's just a vacuum cleaner. It's not actual arcing of circuits. It's just a vacuum cleaner. And you're just annoyed because you just want to get this vacuuming done with. How you deal with this? First, go down to the basement or the garage, turn that breaker back on. Now you can't just flip it straight to on. You got to turn it to off and then fully back on. It'll stay on. If you try and just push it on from the tripped position, it won't stay on. What you need to do to keep the arc fault interrupter from having more of those nuisance trips is use a surge protector. You probably got one of these around the house. They're pretty cheap. You can get them pretty much anywhere. Pretty much anywhere. Plug that into the outlet and then plug the vacuum cleaner cord into the surge protector, and that'll create enough of a buffer to not get those nuisance trips with the arc fault circuit interrupter. It's quite a mouthful. That's why we call it AFCI. Once you've got that up and running, if you do continue to have any issues with the breaker shutting off or any power fluctuations, please get in contact with a licensed electrician. Have them check it out. Hopefully, having this surge protector as a buffer between the vacuum and the arc fault interrupter should be enough to keep the nuisance trips from happening anymore for you. Like and comment down below, because I would love to hear any questions or concerns you have about your house and keeping it in tip-top shape. Thanks for watching. This is Jeff Geisinger with Livin' MN, Loop Team Real Estate.